Challenge accepted, Rogers. Let's see how many dangles I can do in 30 seconds. Here we go. There you go. Let's keep this thing going. I challenge Biz and Pavel Barber. Let's see what you got.
Now, after posting my response to McDavid's challenge on Twitter as well as TikTok, there was a lot of conversation about the fact that I was doing it on the ice and he did it off the ice, as well as the spacing between the pucks. Mine were further apart, which I agree with. Pucks further apart definitely made it easier to squeak through there. I didn't really agree too much with the off-ice. I think off-ice isn't too much more difficult as long as you got the plastic slick enough and the puck's not rolling too much there. But nonetheless, I responded to that, wanted to make sure I did the challenge properly, so I put the pucks closer together and I took the challenge off the ice as well. Okay guys, now it's time to officially enter this Infinite Dangles challenge. Connor McDavid called me out. He did this off the ice. I only had on ice available to me in Toronto, so we're gonna officially enter right now. Back in Vancouver, got my hockey shot, dry land tiles on here, so let's see if I could beat his score. Ready? 30 seconds on the clock. Alright, here we go.
What's going on, everybody? Paul Bissonnette here in beautiful Vancouver, British Columbia. And, you know, I'm just trying to enjoy retirement, ride into the sunset, continue to bump out banger podcasts for our fans. And I get a text message today that Connor McDusty has challenged me to the Infinite Dangles Challenge. I don't know if this guy's seen my game tape from when I played. And I know I used to fight and be a bit of a meatball, but boys, velvet and steel, okay? So I tell you what, Connor, I'm going to take this 30 seconds and embarrass you on the national stage. Okay, you know the name of the game. 30 seconds, as many figure eights as possible, folks. I think you know Connor's number by now. You probably cheated too. Pasha, you going to start the clock for me?
Yes, sir.
All right, let me get warmed up. Oh yeah, thank you to Evgeny Malkin for sending over this beautiful tracksuit. Hopefully the hands come with it. Anyway. Let me get loose here. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah, baby. All right, Pasha, you ready to start that clock?
Yep.
As soon as I come around this puck here.
Okay.
That's when you start it, all right? 30 seconds, folks. Velvet and steel, velvet and steel. And go. Not a great start. I can even do it with my eyes up. getting better. How much time, Pasha?
Got 10 seconds. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time.
Not too bad.
All right, guys, now for the real challenge. I'm going to try and beat Biznasty's record. He got 10. I'm going to do it left-handed on a balance board here. Probably will look like Biznasty when I do this too. Ready? All right, here we go.
Guys, this next one is the Rogers Infinite Dangles Challenge. So we're seeing how many figure eights we can do here. So we start on the forehand, push around to the toe, and then backhand, heel to heel, and we try and see how many we can do in 30 seconds there.
All right, I'll challenge you to an Infinite Dangles Challenge.
Yeah, you want it? Yeah. All right, let's go.
Pucks aren't nailed down, so
exactly.
One mess up.
Holy, this is the longest 30 seconds
long.
Of life.
It's been like 3 minutes. Too long. It's been like 3 minutes.
3 minutes. Hi, I'm Rebecca Johnston.
Hey guys, this is Matthew Kachuk here.
Bonjour, c'est Anthony Zaclad.
Hi everyone, this is Jonathan Huberto.
Hey, I'm Mark Scheifele.
This is Tyler Sagan.
Hi, I'm Tyler Bertuzzi.
Let's go!
Suck it, Sags.
Okay, guys, there you have it. That's the Infinite Dangles Challenge. Now, I'm going to give you a little tutorial on this. This is actually a great simple drill for you guys to do because you use it a lot. I call these moves curls, where you curl the blade either on the forehand or on the backhand to get it from a front-facing position to load the puck back, either on forehand or backhand. Now, what I like to do on these moves is I like to start at the heel on the forehand and I like to push it and let it roll up the blade to the toe. That way we're able to get it back. Notice how the heel lifts up so that we can drag it back. Now on the backhand, it's a little bit different. We're actually trying to keep it at the heel the entire way and we're driving that top hand off the body in order to curl it back. So I'll give you a close-up view of the blade and then we'll back it up so you can see the full body. This is what it would look like on the forehand and backhand. So front facing, let it roll up to the toe and then pull back and then backhand heel to heel, forehand heel toe, heel heel, heel toe, heel heel, heel toe. You have nice control on the blade there. All right, so here you can see what it would look like on the forehand and backhand side. So it's a fake shot or a fake pass. We start it with the forehand open. We push this puck forward. We rotate this top hand forward so that the heel comes up off the ice as we get it to the toe. So here's what it looks like. Push forward, roll the wrist, heels up off the ice, gets the toe, and then we load it back. And same thing on the backhand. We're gonna push this puck forward like we're gonna fake to shoot or pass. and then we're gonna push that top hand off the body so that we can load it back to the forehand. Okay, so here's what it looks like as we go through. Push, curl, heel, toe, heel, 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 toe, heel, heel.